Hey, what's up guys? In this video, I'm gonna show you a deck which looks kinda weird. It's a really interesting off-meta deck. You have a Mortar Graveyard deck. You have Delivery as well. You have the arrows against like all the bay components. You have a really good matchup against most of them. Arrows are really underrated in my opinion against Lava, and it's really, really nice to have. And against other troops as well. Even if against bats, you make it a negative elixir trade, but they're still fine. You have the bats as well. I really like the bats graveyard push sometimes, like honestly, like to support a cannon card with bats, to bait out the opponent's spell for 2 leaks, such a strong card, they have to unite as a, like a small tank. I'm gonna see you in the first game. Don't forget to subscribe if you guys don't want to miss any videos, and don't forget to put code Morten in the shop. If you guys want to support me, appreciate it a lot. It supports the channel a lot. This allows me to make daily uploads on my English channel. I'm gonna see you in the first game. Let's go. Okay, see you in the first game. And normally you just want to start off kind of passively. Okay, he's going to go for Furnace. We're just going to go for Cannon Card in the back. In my opinion, Cannon Card is a really underrated card. I think it's really annoying for the opponent to deal with the Cannon Card. It's just my opinion, but like against Firecracker, we have the arrows, like optimal. But yeah, it's like my opinion against... it's really hard. If I play against Cannon Card, I feel like it's always annoying because it's not going to die from poison. And if it's, he's going to play something like, I don't know, Poison Zap on it, you can play the bats. So... good delivery here. Delivery is like so strong in defense against like graveyard, against like most of the decks. It's like a small Mega Knight, to be honest. We're gonna go for Knight over here. The Fire Spirit shouldn't splash. Okay, the Knight is doing like a really, it's doing a really interesting way. It's like going straight up to the tower that the Fire Spirit is able to splash here. And that's going to be like really great arrows. Perfect, we hit both furnaces. We have the Firecracker. Mortar connects to the tower. And normally you just want to get some Mortar chip and single legs time, and then in double, it really depends on the matchup. Sometimes you play like, you continue with offensive Mortar, and some matchups you don't even play Mortar anymore, and you just go with Cannon Cards in the back, build up a big push, then go with the Graveyard, and in some matchups you're gonna go with defensive Mortar. So, he needs to go for Fireball over here. Fireball is killing Cannon Card because it's got damaged already, but this is completely fine. I think we're gonna start a big Graveyard push. We're gonna go for Mask here. Mask is like insanely strong, man. Against Lava, you need the Mask, and... yeah, okay, we're gonna go for Graveyard over here. Knight, Graveyard, we're gonna even go with Bats. Like, it's so hard for the opponent to defend. He's gonna go for High Barple, even he's gonna go for Poison like that. He has a Witch. Okay, bro, he's like, he has like a really weird deck, to be honest. But still, like, this is what I meant. It's like really hard for the opponent to stop this push, because sometimes they're gonna go like with an E-Wizard on your Musketeer Knight push, or with a Mega Knight, then you can just go with 2 Elixir Bats, and if they use this spell on the Graveyard, it's like so good defense. Okay, he's gonna go for Balloon. This could be kind of tricky here. We're gonna go for High Mortar. Perfect Mortar placement. Gonna go for Musketeer to the opposite side. Mortar is cleaning up everything, and this is like a really nice game. If he plays like a kind of weird deck, I still think you guys understand at least what I meant with my pushes and why did I do this moves. So he has to spend a Barbell on that. Great Barbell timing by him, but this is like really nice stuff against you just have the Musketeer and bats against air, so it's kind of, you kind of have troubles against like Lava or decks, I would say. But at the same time, you have arrows and delivery, so you don't even need to play like your delivery on the Lava Pups. You can just play them on the backup and then arrow the Lava Pups away. So we're just going to defend like the last couple of seconds, and then it's going to be first game in our tash, in our bag, how you say it in English. And this is going to be game number one. I'm going to see you in the next game. GG's to him, to Skeddy. I'm gonna see you in game number 2. Can we get a next crown? No, we can't. Gonna see you in game number 2. Let's go. Okay, see you in game number 2 against Mario. We're gonna give him good luck. And we're just gonna wait here until he does something. So, I don't really want to cycle Knight in back, because if he's gonna go with an Expo, it's not optimal. So, I think we're gonna cycle Arrows. It's not a move you really want to do. You can even go with Mortar first, but you can go with Bats, but I don't really want to go with a Knight. He's gonna go out with a Knight, so we can do the same. Okay, we have the Musketeer in hand. Can we play? He's gonna go for an Ice Wolf. So it could be Expo. Expo is tough because we don't have a big spell here. We don't have a big spell. So this might be a problem, but we have the Cannon Guard. So we have, it's like the only problem is like the defensive Expo. The good thing is now, he doesn't have Log in cycle, he doesn't have Knight in cycle. So this is gonna be really tough for him to defend. He doesn't have Knight, he doesn't have, Lock and Cycle, so I'm gonna go even with Bats because he just spent his Nado, and this is what I meant. Like, if your opponent is playing the Nado on your Graveyard or like his Lock, we went all in because I knew he didn't have Knight in Cycle, and you need a Knight. against the Kenny card plus Musketeer combination. If he would have rocketed, he would have any elixir, the tower would have fallen down anyway, because I think he was like at 7 elixir, he didn't have log and cycle as well. So really bad situation for us, and for him at least, for him I mean. Then he went to on the nade, like with the nade on the graveyard, because he had to, because otherwise the skeleton would just kill his tower. And then, yeah, then we spent like with 2 elixir bats at the bridge, because I knew he didn't have enough elixir for an ice. So you're just gonna air with the expo here. He played like the expo in a really well placement, like the monster's not gonna reach it. So I think this is a good player. He plays good so far, but we got him like off guard because we did a really smart move in my opinion. So I don't really want to be too aggressive here, but it's like really important for us to always kill the expo. And I think now it's time, that's what I meant like in the first game, with going defensive expo, defensive mortars here, because it's gonna distract everything. And he has to go for, yeah, he's gonna go for an expo here. Where's it gonna pull on? Okay, it's gonna target it. Okay, perfect. Even gonna go for cannon card over here. I could have played the cannon card a bit later, to be honest. But it should be fine. Gonna go for arrows. Arrows are gonna clean everything up. And this should be game at least if we don't do like a really, really big mistake in defense. So gonna go for another mortar here. We're gonna wait here. We're gonna go with bats first, then we're gonna go for musketeer. I have a knight. He's gonna lock this. Gonna go for high cannon card over here. Gonna go for musk. And then we're just gonna arrow all this stuff. And normally we should be able to take it up. Now we're gonna go with bats because he doesn't have 7 in his deck. So if he's gonna go with a knight over here, it's gonna be fine. He's not able, he won't be able to defend like the graveyard flawlessly if we are not like completely unlucky. We are kinda unlucky, but I think, no, it's not gonna be enough yet. Okay, we're gonna go with arrows. We need one more arrows. Bats, we're just gonna cycle here. And this should be it. Really nice game against Mario here. I think he played well, but at the start, he did one mistake. That's like a thing. Who expects this deck? Like, who expects Mortar with Graveyard? We're gonna take it up. Gonna see you next game. Let's go. We'll see you next game against AP Bestie. He's gonna give us the wow. We're gonna go with bats in the back. And like, he's gonna think, like, okay, maybe he plays a minor void break. Like, maybe he plays a balloon quick cycle deck. But he won't expect Mortar Graveyard. So, gonna go for Knight. He's gonna go for Musketeer. I don't really want to go for Musketeer. The reason is why, because I think he has Balloon, so I really want to keep the Musketeer here. Great choice. If you play the Mortar like that, the Balloon is always getting kited, doesn't matter. Oh, I was kind of scared here. It doesn't matter where he's playing the Balloon. Even the safe spot, even like all normally at the bridge, if you play the Mortar like that, the Balloon gets pulled, but it's not, it's getting death damage, but it's fine. It's like a 4/5 trade, he gets some damage in, but it's like the best Mortar placement in my opinion against it, because you at the same time you get some counter pressure as well. We're gonna go with bats here. And I feel like we can go in. I don't think he expects us to have graveyard here. He can't really go for delivery here because the troops are like way too much splitted. Because if he would have went to a delivery, he wouldn't have hit the musketeer or the knight, and we get so much damage. He has to go with a delivery on the graveyard. Really nice delivery timing, to be honest. I think he played that like in a really, really great timing. So we didn't get as much damage as I maybe expected, but still, tower on 1,738 HP, so it's completely fine. And we're gonna go for offensive mortar here. We can do that because we are up at elixir. And this is completely fine. Gonna go for high musketeer here to snipe everything up. He could go with a fisherman. Really great fisherman by him. Maybe not the best musketeer, but this is fine. So we're gonna go with a cannon card, and we're gonna go here with a delivery. I don't really want to get my fisherman pulled, because if my cannon card, if it would have got pulled by the fisherman, the hunter would have just killed it, because hunter does so much damage in like in the range with this range. So we're gonna go for musketeer over here. This shouldn't be a hit. The fisherman was questionable because I still don't think it's gonna be. Oh man! Come on, bro! Come on! Okay, this was unexpected. I don't really want to lose the game. Come on, Morton. Let's go. We're gonna go in here. Is he gonna go for delivery? Yes, he does. And that's what I meant. If you're gonna go for a spell on your graveyard, you need to spam in. We're gonna go in here. We're even gonna go with Mortar at the bridge here because he's so low on elixir. He has to snowball it. and the mortar should lock on. We're gonna take it up. That's what I mean. He spent delivery. You need to wait for that, and then you're gonna go with the bats at the bridge to punish him. This is like really, really nice, and this is like a nice advantage to have in this deck. You're just gonna go with this over here. We're gonna go with knight. Okay, he's doing like a great job in my opinion. But if he's gonna go now with a snowball, what he does? Gonna do this. We're gonna go with bats like low, and we're gonna take it up 3 out of 3. And I'm gonna see you in the next game. Let's go. So guys, here in the next game, or like better say in the last game for this episode, and let's see what is he playing. We could go with a mortar here. My only concern is if he has magic archer, but I don't really want to side with the mask. So I think mortar first play is kind of fine. He's gonna go for hunter. It's fine. It was a bad ice bird. I think he has RG. Okay. I think he has RG. Maybe not. He spent a ton of elixir here, honestly. I think we're gonna go in. This was an early lock. Oh, I thought the tower's gonna hit the knight. It would have been so good for us. It's still fine. We still get a ton of damage. But if the tower wouldn't have focused, that's like kind of random. It's like completely RNG. You can't really control this. If his tower would have focused my knight would have tanked for the last guidance. It would have been so good, so much more damage. I think like tower would have went to 1.5, 1.4 HP, 1.4k HP. But he still could have played a spell on it. I don't really know his deck. Okay. That was well played by us, but that's what I exactly mean with magic arch. That's like the only problem with the mortar. I think if we still get one hit, then we should tie the game up, kinda. If we even go in front. It was like a nice arrows, magic, arrows, void delivery combination on the magic archer. Arrows plus a mortar hit is killing the magic archer. Same for a mortar hit plus log is killing the magic archer. So completely fine. He has a royal log stack. Was kinda surprised with that, but I should have. I didn't really think about it because mini packer, yeah, with mini packer hunter, it has to be warlocks here. So great fireball by him. It's gonna get splashed, unfortunately. And we're gonna go for a mortar over here. Why are we gonna go for mortar over here? The reason is because then he can't really magic archer that. Because if he's got, if I'm gonna play the mortar here, he always gets magic archer value, and I can't really do anything against it. If I go for mortar over here, it's fine. We get so much chip in. We're even gonna go for mask over here. It's gonna outrange the hunter. And then we're gonna go with a graveyard. Is he gonna go for mini pack at the bridge? We're gonna go with bats here because he doesn't really have anything against bats. That's what I mean. These bats are so hard for him to defend. Now he has to play an ice golem, 4 elixir on this push. Skeletons are gonna get his tower. This is like really, man, this deck is insane. This deck is insane. Gonna go for graveyard with a cannon card in the back. We didn't even play it yet. And we can just do this. We can just do this. Everything dies. Perfect. Perfect defense. Really, really nice. And this should be it. We can even go for Grail. Come on, we're gonna disrespect him here. We are not the nicest guy on earth. He's just to display something on defense. We're gonna go for high mortar over here because the Hawks would have got pulled by the cannon cut anyway. This was a really nice video. If you guys don't wanna see any deck tip guide videos in the future, or like don't want to miss any deck tip guide videos in the future, don't forget to subscribe to the channel for free. Don't forget to put code MORT in the shop. Appreciate it a lot. Supports me and the channel extremely well. And I'm gonna see one of my next videos. Thanks for watching, guys. Peace out. Goodbye. See you tomorrow.